looking for an exciting game tonight, although how it plays out in terms of its exciting fashion, well, that remains to be seen.
Ignatius has got all the tradition, all of the glory, all of the glamour. New Albany has hopefully the hunger to knock them off. They got to be brave. They got to attack. They got to be willing to fight hard for 80 minutes.
New Albany with first kick to begin the match.
Andy had a chance to visit with the folks on the field. What do you think?
Well, it was an interesting different ways of looking at things. New Albany clearly is the underdogs coming in. It's their first time here in the state championship. But they're going to come, according to Coach John Mellory, they're coming out to play. But the big thing is they need to keep their emotions in check. They have to be in control. But they don't want to sit back and absorb some pressure. They want to take the game to St. Ignatius. St. Ignatius, on the other hand, has been here many times. And their coach, Mike Crawford, says we need to do what we've done all season, just take the game.
All right, we'll see how it plays out, won't we, over the next 80 minutes and perhaps then some. Just this is the sixth of six state championship titles to be determined on the weekend, all three for the girls yesterday, divisions two and three for the boys today. And in the prior five games, we've only had a single overtime contest. Will this change tonight? Well, we're going to find out soon enough.
New Albany on the front foot now. Good pace wide. Good cross.
Opportunity knocks. Okay. Nobody's home.
First chance to New Albany. That's got to encourage them. Harris, the junior, playing on the left side of midfield, showed some real good pace, but here comes Ignatius.
Well, they are a complete team. They have a combination of skill and speed in the attack. Very consistent defensively. What size the team has, because they are a little bit small by comparison to many, but what size they do have is across the back line. Keep an eye on number 10, Remock. An outstanding player.
Win by Trickett
on the attack. Narrowly misses out on the connection there.
Trying to find Dakota. Just misses him. These front five for Ignatius, very well balanced, very technical players, very quick, very fluid in their movement off of the ball, as you can see there. They're all dangerous.
St. Ignatius arrived after regional wins over Solon and Maslin Jackson and then beat a very talented Medina team in the semifinals. It was Pickerington North, Thomas Worthington, and then in the semis, St. Xavier out of Cincinnati, the teams that were put down. All tight games.
Oh, that cross almost found its way in too.
Shot deflected and it's in!
There it is. Early goal. Number 20, Spicer. Ball bounced out to him. He's standing on top of the 18. He kills it with his left foot. Buries that chance. Just the start Ignatius was hoping for, and obviously New Albany needs to regroup. Lots of time.
That's the worst possible scenario for New Albany. They did not want to give up an early goal.
But what a good strike that was.
Indeed. There you go. Nolan Spicer. And you think about the scramble in the goal mouth just moments before the goal was scored by St. Ignatius when it looked like New Albany may have gotten the first break of the game.
Play allows them to penetrate up the flank now. Ignatius. Trickett. This is the left back getting forward now. Sullivan.
And did so very well. Zebra. Albrecht drops deep in the middle, restarts the attack.
Ignatius, it looks like the back four and the holding midfield player folds. Very, very disciplined in the shape that they keep and the way they keep possession of the ball. And they set the platform and the stage for getting the ball forward to the very, very talented group of five attackers.
New Albany bench asking for their guys to step up a little bit higher. As you alluded to, there's plenty of time. How much of it do you want to spend just sliding back and forth in the midfield?
Ignatius, because of that early goal, they're in no hurry.
On the move. Spicer got a touch, and again, it's Noah Zebrek.
Very mature team tactically. They go in, they probe. They don't find anything up front before they lose possession unnecessarily. They just back the ball out, change the point of attack, and go again.
Good room in the middle, and no hesitation on the shot.
Onodi.
Spicer gets a goal. Onady comes in pretty darn close. Easy for you to say. Keep an eye on Onody as well. Ball in the attacking half of the center circle. Zebrak applies the pressure. And the deflection benefits the guys in white, New Albany. As in, really not what was necessary by Kist.
He's got a little bit of soccer in him, though, doesn't he? He moves off the ball well. He's technically clean. Kist seemed to be playing the role of the number 10 for the playmaker for New Albany. Remak.
Great cutback.
Not too much on the dribble there. Just wins it back.
Remak. Turns out to be a long dribble to space. And the ball is cleared by Greg Wiener. I wouldn't say it's been all, but it's largely been St. Ignatius here in the opening. Seven coming up on 8 minute mark.
Yeah, this is what they do. In the semifinal, Medina was able to hold them off the scoreboard until 6 minutes to go in the game, lost 2-0. But I think that's a key, is you can't let them score a lot of goals because you'll never catch them. Good footwork there.
And a deserved goal to make it two.
And that is Remak. Number 10, Marco Remak. He's the only senior of the five front attacking players. 2 and 7 minutes and 10 seconds. That's not a good start for New Albany.
Well, fair to say New Albany hasn't faced anything like this St. Ignatius team.
There aren't many teams like them in the high school ranks.
It's not an exaggeration. They are significantly talented at every position on the field. They don't have to hide anybody. They don't lack depth. And they're not going to take their foot off the gas.
An example of that is they won the state championship last year, started 11 seniors, had an additional, I believe, 5 seniors in the team. So they lost 16 seniors from last year's state championship team. And here they are, undefeated, up 2-0 early in the game, in the state final again. They just reload.
Indeed they do. Well,
dribbler, creates a little bit of space for himself, and then what a wonderful strike right in the corner.
Pretty sure the assistant pointed to the corner.
I thought so too. I thought they were going to take a corner kick.
Perhaps overruled by the center. Another attack.
Very unselfish the way they play the ball around, aren't they? Just on to the next player that's open, give it to the next player that's open, give it to the next guy that's open. Keep the ball moving until somebody has a chance to shoot.
Technical error, ball ends up out of bounds. Really compressing the right side of the field from an attacking perspective for New Albany, and not an easy out, and the ball's turned over. Stumble, play on given.
Trick it.
Play on they will. Sullivan working there.
Trick it just barely offside, so we'll have a free kick for New Albany.
Yep.
Coming out, give them a chance to get forward.
Yeah, the two of them, Trick it and Sullivan, really working hard.
Albany needs to get a hold of the ball, don't they, and build some confidence through possession.
Getting one another's way, and then the smart thing is just under those circumstances, just get rid of the ball.
Throw in Ignatius.
Just
finished the first 10 minutes of the 80.
St. Ignatius with the 2-0 lead.
There. Good interception by Nilo.
The note he did a little bit more than he needed to do there, try to pull off the heel touch on a one-time ball on a diagonal into space behind would have probably served his purpose well.
Well done again by Milo. He's got some soccer in him. Left-sided midfield player, central midfield player, Ian Jacob Baring, the number 10. They've got going to have their hands full tonight with some defending.
Into the channel right side. And a throw-in. Fans like it. Machota on the dribble. After it again. Quickly serves. It's blocked. They'll start anew. Back pass. Flighted ball into the box. Good work in the air by New Albany. Still defending. 28 minutes to go in the opening half. It's 2-0 to St. Ignatius. Well defended. 1v1 against a highly talented player.
Marco Rimac has got some juice. There's no doubt about it. One-on-one. I haven't seen many players in high school with that kind of ability.
Hit swinger, tight to goal. It's hard to tell exactly who it came off of as it found its way into the mixer.
A couple changes for New Albany.
We'll get the official call on those moves. Meantime, goal kick on its way. It is cool, 48 degrees, the kickoff. off temperature. It's breezy. The forecast is actually for the temperature to rise.
5, Nick Fisher. Replaced by 7, Gabe Anthony. And 17, Ryan Blackburn. Replaced by 12, Oliver Cush.
There's just a level of sophistication amongst the St. Ignatius players that we really haven't seen all day today. There's a calmness in their demeanor and how they play the game that's just very, very different.
Like their coach said, Andy, they're just going to do what they do. They're going to play their game, and they're good enough that they're able to enforce their game on you.
Tumble on the foul.
That was Spicer, I think, that picked that ball up. It was off on a run until he was taken down.
Getting a little compressed in the center channel above the penalty area. Chip had it up, deflected, and to the corner.
The front group are very interchangeable, aren't they? Remock has stayed pretty much out on the right, Trickett mostly on the left. They're not afraid to mix it up. Good corner kick. Good clearance.
Yeah, it was a good win, wasn't it? Now, the one comment I would make thus far about the St. Ignatius attack is that their spacing up high could be a little bit better. They tend to get a little compact that draws in New Albany players, and suddenly there's not a lot of daylight. You really have to manufacture something like that. Keep her up high, didn't actually touch the ball, and then wound up in the post. They need a second to gather himself up.
Yeah, they do tend to play very narrow, the front group, but I wonder if that's as a result of playing on the high school football fields all year long. We've talked many, many times about what a difference it is when these teams get here and play on this much bigger, much wider field.
You'd say, but wait a minute. St. Ignatius were just here last year, but as you already pointed out,
none of these guys play.
It's a whole different roster of guys playing.
We need Mel to stay. We, first mover needs her.
It's very, very good movement over the ball.
I think I've
ever seen. Got the Picada. Combination. Anody called from behind.
Well, New Albany's just, they're stuck. They can't get a hold of the ball long enough. They can't get into the attacking half of the field. And they have to be very careful because you've got so many players for St. Ignatius that are so good on the ball that they're going to invite you in. They want the contact, and then more often than not, they're going to get fouled.
So, Marco Remock's brother, Joseph Remock, is preparing to enter the game.
Why not?
It is the younger brother. Joseph is a junior, I'm sorry. Yeah, he is younger. Junior and a senior.
A little bumping and grinding going on there as players try to find a little bit of room to maneuver as they anticipate this free kick coming in. Not the best angle from a finishing perspective, but we'll see. Ball bent at the 6, corner kick.
Really nice service by Marco Remock. A lot of pace, a lot of swerve to it. Hit into a dangerous spot as well.
Maybe we should just assume that it's Remock on the ball all the time. Because
it might be now that here comes his brother Joseph. Substitution in the 17th minute for St. Ignatius. 21, Zombor Anoni, replaced by 66, Joseph Remock. Corner kick, St. Ignatius.
It's a good bent ball in and another good clearance. One thing they have done consistently well here in the first half, New Albany, is they're very good at back in the air.
Nice play. A little counterattack by New Albany now.
Well, it was was, I agree with you, John, that was a very good counterattack. And let's go back again and remind the folks that before St. Ignatius got their first goal, it was actually a great chance for New Albany. They weren't able to finish it, and you just can't help but wonder, might that have changed the dynamic a bit?
Yeah, an early goal for them would have maybe startled Ignatius a little bit. I gotta believe they have not been behind in a game yet this year.
It is better, though, for New Albany.
Yeah, it's a good win again in midfield by Bilo.
But not a great decision for one of your deep players coming forward. This isn't the place on the field you want to take somebody on the dribble, because the response on the back end could potentially be significant. How about that for confidence?
So Marco Rimac has now moved to the center forward role.
And that's a little tug from behind, and then the ball played after the whistle. We'll see if the referee has something to say about that. It doesn't appear to be so.
Ashton Milo will serve this one in there. Good swerving ball, but a little bit too far away from the danger zone.
Foot race to that ball, and it's going to be a throw-in for St. Ignatius in the blue and gold.
Dakota just in midfield kills the ball. He never loses the ball. He's aware of space. When he receives it, he takes it into a good space. Chases and fights to win the ball back when his team loses it. Good little player.
We were watching their warm-up, and as you said, and speaking firsthand, given your professional background, it was like watching a pro team prepare.
Yeah.
And Makota was
different level.
Yeah. Just, it's hard to explain the things he was doing.
Simple.
He makes difficult things look simple.
That's the way to put it. Yeah, it just simplifies the game. With the service.
Well, that's very difficult to make anything happen when you drive a ball straight at goal from a distance. You need to try something, even if it's a short give and go off the restart, but something to change the angle, to force players to move. Good 1v1 battle there.
Sullivan, the left back for Ignatius, does get forward quite a bit, has done so this evening. Not so much the right side, where Morini patrols defensively.
Let's see if New Albany can make something work out of this. Anthony working down the right side. In the end, it's a turnover.
New Albany's grown into the game a little bit here. The game has kind of leveled out a little bit better.
You can't make important decisions like eating peanut butter.
Spicer, nicely done. Change in the point of attack by Makota.
Never quit. Even when it was pretty clear that ball was going to cross the end line.
Substitution in the 22nd minute for New Albany, 12 Oliver Cush, replaced by 17 Ryan Blackburn.
Last 10 minutes have pretty much been much better for New Albany. They have grown into the game. They feel a little more confident they can play with St. Ignatius.
Is it a result? result of St. Ignatius taking the foot off the gas pedal a little bit, maybe.
Yeah, I think maybe a little bit, but I don't think it's going to be any more than that, because the depth of the bench, if they're not delivering, I think you're going to see a few specific changes long enough for the coaching staff to make a point or two. But you just, you know, every time they attack, there is legitimately an opportunity for a goal. That's how good they are offensively. And attacking players, working back to try and dig the ball out.
I love how hard Pakoda works as a central midfield player. Often, you know, a guy that's your playmaker will kind of not do the defensive chores. Just rely on his ability as an attacker. But he works very hard on both sides of the ball. Doesn't have a lot of size to him. Doesn't seem to impact the way he plays.
New Albany really hasn't been able to affect the central defense. It's been balls like that, flighted into the center of the box that have been cleared away. But most of the play has been on the flanks. They just get squeezed out.
That's much better pressure up the field from New Albany. Maybe they were showing too much respect early on in the game. And now they're, well, with that, they're caution to the wind. We're already down two. We might as well just relax and play.
Inside 16 minutes to go. Excuse me there, John.
I was going to say, Anody getting ready to return to the game for Ignatius.
Joyce is out on the left side. New Albany does a nice job of recovering. Baseline move, cross. And
a little bit too much by Sullivan there.
Yep. First glance, I thought so, but the referee said, play on. Tough angle, but on target nonetheless.
Well, he just dribbled by four players.
A little swerve of the hips, and then he you don't know which way he's going to go. And then he's behind you by the time you figured it out.
So composed on the ball, not afraid to play into tight space. You know, it's not going to work 100% of the time, but it doesn't have to. It's going to work most of the time. And then it just becomes a question of how their finishing is on a given night.
A good bit of defending by this left center back, Basic, right there. The center back combination, Basic and Zebrock, obviously very, very good, very well coached. Always in good positions.
This is better from New Albany. This is their best spell of possession.
Yeah. They've settled in a little bit finally. Unfortunately, as everyone knows, they've given up two.
Not much they can do with that ball.
No, they have been playing better. They've had more of the possession than earlier in the match. But they really aren't creating much danger in the attacking third. Just that last ball we saw flighted towards the top of the penalty area and just headed along, and there was nobody else forward.
Decent defending there by Hayes.
And you're in a one-on-one with Remont.
Spicer loses it. There's a good ball.
Yeah, that's a nice pass. He needs to make the run now. They could have gone back to that space. Ryan Blackburn comes off the backside.
There's another good chance. They need to find a way to utilize Harris out there. He's getting behind the defense quite easily with that speed that he has.
Well, like the pass, you noted it, from Blackburn back in the mid-third was really well played, right pace, the right spot. But then he just became a spectator. Had he taken off, the ball could have come right back into him. And that's how close New Albany is. They just get that run right. But they have every reason to be more confident now. Just need to fix up things in the attacking area of the field, get the ball into the box a little bit. It's good work defensively. Clever idea to dummy to himself. Be careful here. Smart decision.
With the Noti coming back in as soon as the ball goes out of bounds, if they go back to the way they were with Remock wide, Marco Remock wide, he was so much more dangerous out there than he's been in the role of the center forward.
Notice how well Sullivan did to avoid the slide tackle.
Well, caught by there too against Spicer.
Not a happy ending that time.
They look, like you say, New Albany just doesn't look dangerous when they go forward. But Ignatius looks dangerous every time they go forward.
Well, that was what we expected coming in. New Albany's been very, very good in tight games. And they don't want to let this one become any larger of a deficit. They could get in a 2-0, maybe even find a way to get a goal, but you don't want to be down 3 or 4-0, because that's how quickly things change.
Dakota again combining.
Substitutions in the 30th minute for San Ignatius, 10, Marco Remock, replaced by 21, Zombor Anodi. And 15, Nate Trickett, replaced by 6, Antonio Marini.
It's a very young San Ignatius team as well. I think they only have 2 seniors on the field. Everyone else is a sophomore or a junior.
Yeah. So this is the next wave of state championship wins that we're looking at.
Well, they represent the truest sense of reloading. There's just talent aplenty. So they go from having having 18 seniors on their roster to being a decidedly younger side this year.
I would imagine that a lot of their inner squad training games are more competitive than some of the other high school teams they play throughout the regular season. Probably not the playoffs.
Something in that after the fact.
Mom.
Yeah?
Your computer has something, like a game going on it.
What is it?
Yeah, it's playing, it's recording.
Oh.
Good switch.
Chloe gets sent to social services. I'm going to find another way to help her and Lou.
The first touch for every one of these guys is clean. Ball doesn't squirt away, it doesn't pop up. It goes right where they want it to.
Shield the ball well, everybody.
Even a forced pass works its way out. Is it wider help? Shot taken. Oh, it's a beauty.
You're right about the first touch, Dwight. It's really nice to see the control that they display.
Substitution in the 32nd minute for New Albany. 7 Gabe Anthony replaced by 22.
Luciano Pachoda.
Dakota.
Dakota continues to be a dynamic presence on the field.
Driving force.
And if you notice, pretty much 95% of the passes are on the floor. And they keep the ball down for the most part.
They're a very small team, really.
Where did Edwin Mullins speak?
A couple of the back.
chance is taken by Zebrak, just cleans it up, gives his team a chance to get back and organize defensively. But initially, he may go back to the goalkeeper, but hard to hear their conversation from the broadcast position, and maybe that he was instructed to go wide.
I think they're well aware of the pace of Harris out there, too. They certainly just don't want to take any chances.
Big gap between lines for New Albany.
There aren't many teams that are going to be confident enough to play the ball out of the back like this.
There's nothing even to say about that.
Spin turns out of trouble like it was nothing. There was a handball there. Uh-oh.
It certainly looked like it was going to be three.
That was a great run by Josip Remak there with the ball, weaving his way through.
Six minutes to go in the half. Quick pair of goals from St. Ignatius has them up over the Eagles by a 2-0 scoreline. It was nearly three just moments ago. Basic comes out to the left side for Sullivan. Barzacchini goes backward, pass rotates. Zebrak's got plenty of room. He takes it. A nice little entry ball. Shot struck well, but wide.
He's very good at it. As balls are played into his feet, he's already taken a look over his shoulder. He knows he can turn with the ball. He wastes no time in getting turned and getting behind the midfield line and running right at that back four. Does young Mr. Pakoda. And then he's got a cannon with that right foot, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
He's got two near misses.
What you might call an undersized player just demonstrates how important technique is. A rare giveaway out of the back. But cleaned up. Will play Zebrak. Soul hasn't had a whole lot to do in goal. Maybe that'll change.
This is better for New Albany. This is their chance right now. Get a free kick down in the third.
We have an injured player.
Looks like Harris has gotten injured somehow. Maybe his shoulder when he went down. It looks like he's holding.
Hey,
let him do. It would be a shame if they've lost him. He's been very effective out on the left.
Well, that is.
Clock is paused. 3:29 remaining in the opening half. Pair of goals has St. Ignatius in the lead by a 2-0 score line. New Albany, as the half has progressed, has played themselves much more into the game, but has not really been dangerous in or around the penalty area, save one opportunity that came almost at the outset of the game before St. Ignatius had scored. And had they been able to finish that opportunity off the road 1-0, who knows where we might be.
But, you know, they're a place where...
It's like maybe a shoulder injury, doesn't it? The way Harris is holding his arm.
Yeah.
Let's be honest.
No time like the present.
The 37-minute for New Albany. 14, Derek Harris. Replaced by 7, Gabe Anthony.
Got to wait for the whistle, so a little over anxious on the restart.
A little short, that one.
Yeah, you got to at least give yourselves a chance. Look at this pace. 2-on-1 into the final third. New Albany trying to recover. Individual go.
Nice tackle.
And then they just reset.
Kist comes away with that challenge. Plays it wide.
Left channel. Good cutback. Not a bad angle to shoot. And a pretty well struck ball.
They got to be gaining confidence from this little stretch of time here, and if they don't give another one up, they'll be looking forward to the second half, I think. You just got to be careful not to let yourself down, let your guard down, and allow another goal.
We'll step over.
Nice tackle. Good defending there.
Yeah. 2 minutes remain.
Harris did come off with a shoulder injury. He's icing it down now.
And they need him to return to the game.
They need to throw this right in front of the goal and hope something good happens. But they need to get over the first line of defenders.
There's times that all you could do is just try to slide in and knock the ball away.
Some of these guys can dribble their way out of a phone.
Yeah.
1 minute, time remaining.
Well, interestingly enough, they could do it with the door closed. I have to explain to our younger audience what a phone booth is. Deft little touch. Most players wouldn't even see that, let alone have the confidence to play the pass in. Division One state championship game from Moffray Stadium. St. Ignatius leads New Albany.
St. Ignatius 2, New Albany 0.
We'll be back.
Association would again like to remind spectators to follow all state requirements for your own health and safety, as well as the health and safety of others. Please wear a face covering at all times, maintain 6 feet social distancing from others not from your household, and do not gather before, during, or after tonight's event. Thank you for your cooperation. For the latest Ohio High School Athletic Association news, visit their website, ohsaa.org. along with our other social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Be sure to connect with OHSAA Sports for brackets, scores, news, photos, and more. Programs for the OHSAA State Championships are currently on sale. All state qualifiers, state championship history, and lots of other exciting features are available. Pick up your copy of the program tonight. Fans and student athletes participating in tonight's contest, thank you for your tremendous support throughout the season. Let's act with dignity, speak with courtesy, and play with pride. On behalf of the OHSAA and everyone participating in tonight's championship event, please remember to respect the game. Everyone is a champion when you grab fresh hot chicken fingers, world-famous cane sauce, garlic butter Texas toast, crinkle-cut fries, creamy coleslaw, and fresh-squeezed lemonade from Raising Cane's. Raising Cane's, proud partner of the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Mercy Health is proud to be the official healthcare partner of the OHSAA. Mercy Health cares for and treats the most student-athletes in the state of Ohio. Visit mercy.com/ortho to learn more. Greatness is built with chocolate milk, the official beverage of the OHSAA. The American Dairy Association Mid-East reminds you that low-fat chocolate milk has the right mix of fluids, carbs, and protein to rehydrate and refuel muscles. Is your team built with chocolate milk? For more information, visit drink-milk.com. You don't dream of simply playing soccer, you dream of dominating it. Wilson exists to push you so the distance between your dreams and reality becomes a little shorter. Wilson, the official soccer ball of the OHSAA. Learn more at Wilson.com. EA Graphics is proud to be the new official OHSAA State Tournament Merchandise Partner, connecting our successful family-owned and operated business of producing souvenir apparel with OHSAA tournaments. Whether it's t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, or other apparel items, be sure to pick up your state championship merchandise today or online at ShopOHSAA.com. Follow your favorite teams by downloading the Max Preps fan app or go to maxpreps.com on your mobile device. Max Preps, proud partner of the OHSAA. Final Forms is a proud sponsor of the OHSAA. Ohio-based, Final Forms leads the way with sports registration for the compliance, health, and safety of our athletes. See finalforms.com for more. Health Action Council is honored to be a new partner of the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Wishes good luck to all participants in this year's state tournament. We're excited to work with Ohio schools in developing high-quality and more affordable health benefit solutions for your employees during these unprecedented times. Health Action Council, enhancing business, enlightening lives, enriching communities. Visit us at healthactioncouncil.org. Is it almost time to renew your Ohio license plate? When it is, don't forget to donate $1 to the Save Our Sight program. It funds Super Specs and helps us get protective eye equipment to kids across the state. Today, we've donated more than 240,000 pieces of equipment. Thanks, Ohioans.
Yeah.
about set to kick off the second 40 minutes here at Mopray Stadium, the boys Division I high school state championship game. The defending champions from St. Ignatius lead the upstart New Albany side, making their first appearance ever in a state final. It is 2-0 and a rugged start, John, for New Albany. St. Ignatius took advantage, but as the half progressed,
St. Ignatius with
the Eagles
to begin the second
got a little stronger.
Ignatius taking their foot off the gas or not, I don't know, but I think once you go up 2-0 that early, you tend to relax a little bit. New Albany, you know, they grew into the game a little bit more. They settled down when they had a chance to play a little bit. They grew in confidence. We'll see whether or not Ignatius turns up the juice now.
Well, once again, it comes down to the first 10, 15 minutes of this half. If New Albany can hang in there and make some opportunities, get a couple chances, the game is not over. But if St. Ignatius comes out and scores, game's over.
I would say that's a good point. Are you sure you're going to be
fish? St. Ignatius in their gold jerseys, navy shorts and socks, white head to toe. New Albany in the second half is underway. An opportunity for the Eagles to soar, get themselves back in this one. Should mention, in case you weren't with us at the time, right at the outset of the game, there was a scramble in front of the St. Ignatius goal, and had New Albany be able to get the right touch to it at the right time, they may very well have gone up 1-0. But that's not the way it played out. Very disciplined team, St. Ignatius. Everybody is good on the ball. They all understand their roles.